Yeah, that's all hypergamy though, Ben 838. You're saying that you know, as soon as you go broke, women leave you. The women don't leave men when they go broke straight away, right? The reason why the women leave men, right, when they go broke is because they lose their confidence. That going broke, right, simulates, right, hard times. Yeah? A woman needs to be with a man who's a strong individual, a strong character. Can he overcome adversity? I said it in live streams, maybe live stream yesterday, I maybe even said it earlier, right, about overcoming adversity. If you cannot overcome adversity, that is a feminine trait. All that, I'm being oppressed, oh, the world is against me, I can't get nowhere because of the color of my skin, that is feminine energy. Yeah, so women leave men when they go broke and they have no money. Not because they're broke and they have no money. Now, some gold-digging women who are with that man because he has money, yeah, they will leave that. They will leave that man. But if a woman is with a man because of the strength he has, even if he goes broke, right, she will still stay with him. You've got a certain amount of time to get your stuff back together and get back on your feet. You don't have to have a £1 million house like you did before, but you need to, she wants to see progression, yeah? You've got a certain amount of time. Then she probably will leave you, innit, yeah? But she will stay with you if you stay strong. Woman want to know, right, if our house burns down, right, is this guy going to stay strong, right? If they take everything away from us, can this guy, you know, stay strong and protect the family? Or is he going to sit in the corner and quiver like a little pussy up? Yeah, women want to be with a strong man. Yeah? Look, we got Nadia in the stream right now. Nadia's my girl. Obviously, you don't know who Nadia is, isn't it? Yeah. I have not worked since January, yeah? Since I got fired at the end of January. Call it February, innit, yeah? She ain't left me. And I ain't trying to drive a Mercedes, spend all this money here, innit, yeah? Because I ain't shown no weakness. Now, if I got fired from that job and, you know, I was like, oh, God, I don't know what I'm going to do. Yeah, lost my confidence. Yeah, lost my strength. Yeah, then she would have been on. Yeah, she would have kept it moving. You got to keep that strength, man. But you can't fake that shit. It's either you are that or you're not. Yeah? There's no, you don't watch all these dating coaches, all these strategies and that. It's either you are that or you're not. Either you're a strong man or not. Yeah? You can become a strong man, but that takes time. Yeah, that takes time. Yeah. Yeah, Nadia. Women like, women hate laziness. Women, as I always say in my videos, right? A woman would rather meet a guy who's here and over the years he progresses and he reaches this point, right? Rather than meet a guy who's even above that, but he stays there. No woman wants a man who's stagnant. A woman would rather a man, let me remove this so you can see what I'm saying. Hold on. Well, you lot. Banging in the comments. Well, I had to go all the way up to hide this comment. Right. A woman would rather meet a man who's down here and over the years he gets to this stage, right? He progresses. So he starts off down here and over the years she sees improvement. Yeah. Not dramatic improvement. Yeah. But just gradual improvement. He's always trying new things. Yeah. Even if he goes up and down, up and down, up and down. But she would rather over the course of the relationship, he starts off here and he ends up here. Rather than meet a guy who is here from day one, but he stays here. Yeah. Women want to know, say that a man is always improving, yeah, always progressing. Yeah. Being stagnant, that's not a good thing. Yeah. Being, that's not good. I don't give a fuck if you earn £1 million, right? Find a way to earn more money. Yeah. It's not about the money. It's always trying new things, always improving your life. Yeah. We are here to prosper. We are here to succeed. We are here to always better ourselves. Yeah. If the world did not think like that, we would still be driving automobiles. Yeah. You know, the old cars. Yeah. Fucking 8-liter engine that don't even fucking breach 30 miles an hour. We will still be driving automobiles. What's wrong with an automobile? It gets you from A to B. Yeah. Well, why are we not still driving those cars? Because people always want to improve. They always want to better themselves. Yeah. There's certain men out here, they don't like female hypergamy, yeah? Because they don't want to improve themselves. Yeah, me, it don't matter to me. I don't give a fuck, yeah? Because I know I'm always going to be improving. Shit, motherfucker. So yeah, I like that. 2-0 at halftime and then 3-2 at full time. Yeah? Overcome the odds. Yeah, there's man, I've been in competition, man are beating me in the beginning and I beat them in the end of the at the end of the competition. Yeah. Yeah, Nadia. We want to be proud. Women want to be proud of their men. Yeah. You see that? A woman wants a strong man. And I spoke about this in a video I made the other day. I ain't released it yet, right? But women want a man who can lead their children. Yeah. Women want a man who can teach their sons, especially, how to overcome adversity. No woman wants a man who is going to have a son and raise him to be a little coward. Yeah. Oh, if your manager speaks rough to you, yeah, just take it on the chin. No, a woman wants a man to teach his son. Anyone talk shit to you, yeah, don't have it. Even from me, I'm your father. Yeah. Don't take no shit from no one. Listen, you see, when I have a son, yeah, it's gonna be like fucking military school. Yeah. But I ain't gonna be too harsh on him. Yeah, I'm gonna be trying, yeah, give it to him in drips and jack. I know. You know, you can't be too harsh on the children and that, innit? Yeah, they'll end up being really soft and you don't want to break them, put it this way, innit? But from day one, I'm going to teach my son to be a fucking man.